Alright, hey guys, what's going on? This is Space here. Welcome back to another episode of LEGO Harry Potter. Here's 547, of course. Last time we left off, we did the trial and stuff and whatnot, so... And the Dementors in the beginning. Yeah. Alright, so fun fact, I think this is right. Tonks is actually stationed at Hogsmeade, I believe, if I'm not mistaken, to protect the school. So, it's pretty cool. I know she is in the second, or in the sixth one. But I think she is as well in the fifth one, so that's pretty cool. Also, Dwalish is also here, in not in Hogsmeade, but I think, Hogwarts Station, but I think in, like, Hogsmeade or something like that. He's one of the guys that tries to arrest Dumbledore, but of course that doesn't go well. I think he dies in this seventh one, I don't know. I think so, I don't know, or he, like, gets injured, so I don't know. Freaking whatever, who cares. Alright. Here we go. And as you can see, we still can't use any spells, we just have the one. For some reason, I have no idea why. I guess because in the first game, the first spell you learn is this, I think. Maybe, yeah. And in the first one, you only have one spell at the beginning, so. Anyways, yeah, I do miss the first one, but this one's still pretty good. Like I said before. You're probably hearing me say that a lot, but whatever. So, something they never mention in the movies for some reason is that Ron and Hermione, become prefects, and Harry, kind of wonders why he didn't get chosen. But, you know, he's not all selfish about it, you know, of course, but, he wonders why he wasn't chosen. And so, when he sits down, he sits down with Neville and, Luna in the, Hogwarts Express. Then eventually they come to, Ron and Hermione. And they all go together on this carriage with the Thestrals. This is when you first start seeing the Thestrals. When Harry first starts seeing the Thestrals because he saw Cedric die in front of him, so... Yeah. I guess he technically should have been able to see them before because he saw Lily die, in theory. Maybe not, though, I don't know. But, yeah. Pretty interesting. And then Luna, of course, saw her mother die at, like, I think she was, like, 9 or 10, something like that. She's pretty young. It says in the movie, and in the book, too, I believe, so. Alright, here we go. That's a little too close there, Luna. Hold on there. That looks very weird, I'm not gonna lie. Alright. Sir Nicholas is back, even though in the movies he only appears in the first two, I think. You never see him again, even though he's in the fifth one in the book. He's in all of them, I think. Yeah, he is, but... You don't see him in the movies for some reason. I guess it's just one less actor to pay or whatever, one less special effects piece thing to do, visual effects to do, but you know. Thumbnail, maybe. Aha. Dude, you guys, look up the deleted scenes, right? The extended scenes or whatever of this movie. It's like a freaking, like, the weirdest thing I've ever seen in this movie. It's from that. It's very weird. You'll know it right away when you see it. It's very weird. Sounds like old a waffle to me. Dude, that's freaking forever, man. Wow. What is that thing right there? Is that a piece of cake? That's a weird piece of cake, man. Say, like, yeah, that was great. Woo. Ah, get sucked, boy. Ah, the prophecy. Oh. He's actually the Riddler. What? What, Ron, what are you doing, man? Something they glazed over is that now Seamus kind of despises Harry because of what his mother said in the Daily Prophet and stuff. The Daily Prophet is spreading a lot of bad rumors about Harry and stuff, saying that he's crazy and stuff. Of course, Dumbledore too. And there's a scene that was never in the movie, which really should have been, and that is Harry goes into Hogsmeade. He meets up with Hermione. He has a date with Cho, but then that goes very wrong, and he just storms out of there. Well, Cho storms out of there, and then Harry has to pay and stuff, and then... he goes to the free broomsticks, I believe, if not mistaken. And he goes and he sits with, I believe, Luna, Hermione, and Rita Skeeter from the fourth movie slash book, if you remember her. She was the reporter. And Hermione finds out that she's an Animagus because she's been listening in on them and stuff, which is something the movie never mentions, by the way. For some reason, I have no idea why, but they're just like, you know what, it doesn't matter. You know, who cares about that subplot? And yeah. So he gives his full interview about how what happened in the graveyard and stuff in the third task, so it's pretty interesting. And it gets published in the Quibbler, and then everyone reads it in the school, but then the Quibbler is banned by Dolores Umbridge. We call him Professor, but no, don't do it. Who's this person? Okay. You're welcome, Suck. It's very random. What was I saying? So she bans the Quibbler and stuff, and yeah. Oh, thanks. Very helpful. Ginny Pajamas, of course, always what I wanted. Get out of here, you scrub. Look at this, look how different this looks. It looks very different from the original. Or from the first one, I should say. As you can see, this has been changed before. All you have to do is, like, just... Yeah, I'm dumb. I wasn't paying attention. Green. Alright, I got you. Before, it just opened automatically, but now you have to solve the puzzle, like with the book. And Harry makes these weird, like, hissing noises for some reason, I don't know. Apparently someone has walked in there. Interesting. Something the movie completely glazes over is that Harry, Fred, and George were banned from Quidditch, too. So, there's, like, no Quidditch in the fifth movie for no reason at all. But they're like, hey, let's just not talk about that. Yes. Ah, that's pretty cool. Look at this. Watch that. There we go. Very good, very good. It's a spell you learn later. It's a pretty cool spell. I actually really like that spell. It's pretty cool. Alright, that's interesting. As you can see, Dolores is reforming everything and stuff, you know? Yeah. Yeah, see, like... Yeah, I mean, it's basically the same map, but, you know... Differently lit, I'd say. It looks a little different lighting-wise and stuff. Maybe it could just be that the graphics are better, but actually I do think, like, the lighting is a lot different. So... Alright. What's up, man? Alright. Neville, I think. That looks like Neville. This is, Padma and Pavarti. The Patel twins. One of them is in Ravenclaw, the other one is in Gryffindor, but I don't think that actually is a thing in the movie. I think they're both in Gryffindor for some reason. I don't know why, but, you know. Oh, yes, of course. We're building a Lego plane thing. Let's shoot a movie. Wow, this is, like, really breaking the fourth wall here. This is all being recorded, huh? Alright. Well, actually, it is being recorded. This game is getting a little too self-aware. I'm going to have to uninstall before it freaking hacks my computer. So. Here we go. Ah, what is this? I mean, yeah, I guess. Alright, interesting. Can I just, like, can't get that automatically, huh? Wait, what do you mean? Hold on, what's this? Wrecked. Alright, interesting. What's in here? Yeah, as you can see, I don't have a spell wheel, which is interesting. Very funny. Maybe I do, because I need to, like, get... Only small animals? Alright. Does Hermione not have Crookshanks? Alright, I don't know. I guess I don't have any spells right now? What? I know eventually, like, you have all the spells, but then for some reason, like, you just lose them. Like, magic gets banned from, yeah. Magic expand and stuff, so you don't have all your spells, so that's how they get around that. Since you already learned all the spells in the first one. Interesting. I don't even know what we're doing, honestly. I'm making a potion, but I don't know why. Oh, a strength potion, alright. Got him good, son. Never wants a shovel, apparently. Now where's the cauldron? We have all the ingredients, but where's the cauldron, man? And why is there some dark art stuff over here, man? That's not right. Alright, let's see. How do I get a cauldron? Alright. Oh, this could be it. Yep. Booyah! It still uses the same design for a cauldron, so that's pretty cool. Same mechanics. There's a lot of similar mechanics. There's some updated stuff here and there, but for the most part, it's pretty similar. As you can see now, you can decide what potion you want for some reason, even though you can only have one. Oh, that's not it. How do I... Yeah, man, what do you... Alright, well, that's interesting. I don't know how I did that, but apparently I saved the student by shooting someone. Thank you for saving it, Voldemort. You're very kind. That was interesting. Alrighty. Oh yeah, we're making the paper airplane, that's right. It's very random. I don't understand why this is, I guess because it's in the movie, because they're like, one of the Patel twins makes a, one of the Patel twins makes a paper bird or like hummingbird or whatever, and like it flies around the class and then she sets it on fire or whatever. Then Harry's mad because they're not using, learning defensive spells, like how to use them. Because Voldemort's out there and she's like, oh, enough detention, Mr. Potter. He gets like detention for like a month. Yep, there we go. No more magic. That's all gone. See, you know all of the spells, but now, no. Okay, I like so how you get banned from using all the spells, but look, you still have like a few spells for some reason. That's very, very weird. Oh yeah, you can't use spells. Oh, but you can use your Patronus, and you can use your Lumos. So there you go. Perfect. Sorry, I'm doing what now, Dumbledore? You maze what? There must be a key close by. Huh. You know, there must be, huh? I guess that's what this is for. There you go, this is, I don't know how to pronounce it. But, yeah. Pig. Press Q. I'm pressing Q, thank you, Dumbledore. Dumbledore, I'm pressing Q. I'm pressing Q. Alright, fine. Let's use Crookshanks. Alright, apparently you can't use Pigwidgeon for getting in here for some reason. Interesting. That's the owl that Sirius uses to send Harry the letter on the Hogwarts Express in the third movie, or in the third book. And Ron keeps it because, of course, Sirius got rid of his rat, so his pet, so, you know, yeah. Bloody Birds of Menace. That's actually Arrow, not Pigwidgeon, but you know, whatever. Alright, here we go. Pardon me, scrub. You want a soup ladle? What are you gonna do with that, man? Eat soup, I guess, alright. Why would you steal someone's soup ladle, man? Soup ladle, man, what's wrong with you? Freaking got a mental block or something? Alright. Wow, gee, you're too fast to catch. What am I gonna do if you freaking Tom Riddle lookalike kid? Oh yeah, that's right. Boy, get wrecked. How do I already have this much money? What the heck? I've only been playing for less than 2 hours, man. Actually, less than an hour. It's only been like, I don't know, 35 minutes or something. Oh yes, thank you. Just like in the first one. Wow. Yeah, see, basically the same map, but you know, like all the little stuff that you did in the first one, it's not here, so that's one of the reasons why it kind of kills the nostalgia a little bit. Because there's no stuff that you did. Like, you know, you can change the map and stuff yourself. In a way, you know. There we go. And you'll notice that this is now like this. You know, it used to be like there used to be like the gap and stuff, and you fix the gap. And it also used to be like, not from this point of view, it used to be from like the outside, you see inside. But now it's like inside, you can see outside. Which is weird. I don't know why they did that, but I guess they wanted to change. And as you'll see, the Quidditch pitch is kind of closed right now, so yeah. And also, you'll notice there's no gate down to where the second task is anymore. So it's interesting. Oh, now it works, huh? Alright, whatever. Hagrid was gone, but I guess he's back now? No, maybe not. Professor Grubbly Plank came back and substituted for Hagrid while he was gone. Festral. Harry wonders why he sees him and everyone else doesn't. Throughout the book. It doesn't really, it kind of does that in the movie, but not really as much as it does in the book, but you know. Yeah, I think here's the scene where he finds out why that is, because it does it pretty early on, but then Harry finds it out later in the book, like, a lot later than it does in the movie. Just one of those, like, mysterious things. It's kind of like not really that important, but still interesting. Alright, apparently this is also a quest storyline thing, apparently. Interesting. Honestly, there's like not much probably in this movie for the game to do, so that's probably why this is a quest or storyline, whatever thing. How do I get that fish? Smash roof a boulder, of course. You're welcome, frog guy. Get out of here, boy. Alrighty then. Ah, there we go. I can't deny it. This is probably my least favorite level set in the game, but it's pretty good. But honestly, I don't know. It's just because the movie isn't always. It's good, but it's not. When you compare it to the book, it's kind of disappointing. But okay, all right. Like I said, so though still fun. It's just the other ones are more fun. I feel. Also, if you guys haven't heard, if you have an Xbox and you wanted to play the remastered collection of LEGO Harry Potter, it used to be only released on the used to only be on the PlayStation 4 for some reason. I don't know why that was an exclusive. It's very random, but now it is not an exclusive anymore. Now it is on the Xbox. I think it might be out already. Obviously, I'm not sponsored by LEGO, but that'd be cool. But if I was, I'd be freaking like say, hey, buy all of this stuff. Yeah, so yeah, that's out. Oh, now if you're interested in that. Well, I think it's out. If it's not out yet, then it'll be out soon. I haven't really heard anything about it, because, I mean, honestly, it doesn't affect me at all, since I don't actually have them on the Xbox. So, yeah. I do have them on the Wii, and of course I have them on the computer, which is what I'm playing on right now, if you're wondering. That wasn't clear already. So, yeah. Alright. I like how that becomes a sphere when you, like, destroy it. Even though it's, like, all flabby and stuff, then all of a sudden it's like, yup. Straight. There we go. So sparkly, too. I don't think I was that sparkly in the first game. Interesting. Alright. Yeah, the first one is definitely my favorite. This one is good, but it's not as good. I've already said I told you I was going to say this like a million times, so. Sorry. Yeah, but still, though, yeah, this one isn't as good, but it's still pretty good. I guess it's just that I feel like the first one was like one of LEGO's greatest games. And this one is good, but it just can't hold a torch to the original, you know. Would you like get out of here? Thank you. Yeah. Can I like go? Alright. Boy, how many of these guys are there, man? Get out of here. Stupid gnomes. Alrighty. Where am I going now? Goodbye, gnome. Huh. Well. Yeah, I don't need to know dark magic, boy. Get out of here. Oh boy, where do I go? Is this actually a level? It is. Why is this level? Oh no, it's not. I say what? Is like what? This is alright. Some pets can dig up. yeah, Uni doesn't have any pets, alright. Uni doesn't have any magic either, barely. Alright, I guess what if alright, I guess whatever. Alright, I guess whatever. I guess you can't go across this way? Oh. What? Where's the next guy, man? Huh. Oh, wait a second. Wow, I'm dumb. Alright. I feel like it's up here. Oh, alright. Gah, get glitched. Boy, yeah, there it is. Okay, I'm dumb. Banana. No. Don't care it either, man. This man wants some food, man. Just wants some solid, hungry meat food stuff. Give it to him. Like, you're welcome, dude. Huh, bye, I guess. That is extremely random, I must say. What? Okay. Alrighty. You know, sometimes you just don't question it, I guess. Alright. Well, So thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed that episode. It's very weird. It's very weird. So this pad is for Hermione in the later years, if you're wondering. And, 7 when she has the bag that has, like, all the stuff in it. That's what that's for. So you don't see that yet, but, you know. If you're wondering. Anyways, guys, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed this episode. I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.